know, that's the laboratory. You can see how small this laboratory is.
Yeah.
For a facility this big, you have something the size of, you know, most people would have as, you know, a small second room in a home.
Yeah.
There's no good space in there to do the chemistry that they need to do. Is this right down there?
Yeah. So what is this thing, Mike?
These are the controls for this facility that help us monitor the liquid level in our clear wells. Some of the storage facilities in the city, you'll see it, it'll cycle through Blackburn. Blackburn's about 100 foot tower, 99, that's just about full. Bond Hill's at 12 and a half feet, and 15 and a half full. So they probably didn't run last night at West Boston, probably running right now. So that level of Bond Hill will continue to rise. Plum Cove Tower, this doesn't work here. Should work. Works in West Boston, just doesn't work here.
So this is a paper reading?
These are paper readings. I can grab one to show you. These are the old circle pen charts that, you know, you make sure you start at the right hour. When you get it to the, and the pen drags across the surface of the paper, recording whatever it is it needs to record, whether it's the raw water, finished water, the water level at a storage tank, the turbidity, which is a term we all heard this summer. And if you look at the back of this, it's marked on the back of it, Greg. You can see it's wide open to, very old technology. There's usually a bucket below it that's going to leak to the ceiling.
This is just as bad as the little paper ticker tape we saw down the fire department. That was 1920s technology that recorded the pull boxes in the city.
This is very primitive technology. Back in 1964, it was probably borderlining on old technology. Certainly in 2009, this would be extremely outdated technology. So it's so outdated right now, the operators need to keep paper logs, because you can't really take a look at that chart and say, well, you know, you have 3 hour increments in the course of a half inch. Well, what happened at 6:15? What happened at 6:30, 6:45, 7? It's difficult to know by this, and these type of operations have to be carefully monitored. Difficult to do, so it's a lot of operator work that has to be done to keep logbooks.
So this whole thing is going to be removed
and
replaced?
This needs to be replaced. We need to have modern technology here that the operators can pull up all this information on a computer screen that can be saved, so you know what happened at every minute, second of the day, and it's recorded and logged. This is the raw water intake. It's a single switch. You know, as water comes in too fast, you see the operator trying to jiggle this switch to help stop it. Well, obviously the electrical switch, trying to give some sort of signal to something. It's not good technology. Obviously there's been some stuff added to this. These are the high lift pumps. These are the controls for the finished water pumps there. This is more modern than the rest of this. This is an add-on. But that is still very old. That'll be replaced as part of the valve.
That's all part of the money that was being allocated to.
That was already scheduled ahead of time. We've been trying to be proactive from the 18 months they've been here. Like West Gloucester is all fairly modernized relative to this facility, much different looking facility than this. The pumps were scheduled. Did we anticipate all the work we're doing here? No. We had anticipated replacing the filters this spring, even ahead of what happened this summer. We walked into the filter room.